Hello everyone, welcome to the session on TELNET options learning outcomes. At the end of the session, students will be able to describe the concept of options and sub option negotiation, and students will be able to state the concept of controlling the server. Content, option, sub option negotiation, symmetry, sub option negotiation, controlling the server. These are the topics I am going to cover in this video. About telnet option. Option is a part of telnet. In the previous video, we have discussed about what is telnet, different types of logins, where we have to use the concept of telnet and types of telnet, and the types of logins, local login and remote login, how to use, and then where we have to use, we have discussed in the last video. In this video, we have discussed about the next part of telnet, that is telnet option. Telnet option is an option, is an extra space available to the user to add any extra space in the given packet or segment. Okay. Users with simpler terminal can use default features. The types of options are there. Here, there are so many options we have to use while transmitting the data from one user to the another user. What are the different options types are there? Okay, this is the table can contain some of the options that are, if the table can contain code, option, and meaning why we have to use, what is that option. Okay, here the code are 0, code is in 0, and then option is in binary. It can be used to interpret 8-bit binary transmission. Okay, next code is 1, echo, and then it echoes the data received on the one side of the other. And next, suppress, go ahead, status is there, and then timing mark, that code is in 24, and terminal type, set the terminal type, and these are the different options are there. And then 32 is a code, and then option type is in terminal speed, and set the terminal speed while transmitting the data from one user to the another user. And then code is in 34, and then option is in line mode, change to line mode. The different modes are there: default mode, character mode, line mode. Here we have to change from one mode to the another mode. We have to use the option type is in line mode. In detail, we will study about the different types of modes. That first one is binary. It allows the receiver to interpret every 8-bit character issued data. Okay. Second one is just, it can echo the whatever the data we have received from the client, or in the server side, it can display the client data in the client side, so it can receive, it can echo the receiver received data. Okay, next one is suppress, go ahead. This option suppresses the whatever the data they want to transfer. This we have to use the suppress, go ahead, to transfer the data to the next user. Next one is status. It allows the process running on the client machine to get the status, how much data is already transferred, and then how much data we want to transfer, that we have to get in the status part. Next one is terminal timing mark. It means before transmitting the data, the user should have to mark the timing, how much time it takes to reach the data to the destination. It means it allows one party to issue a timing mark. Next one is terminal type, where it allows the client to send its terminal type. It means whether the client is using what type of operating system, whether the user is using Unix operating system, or DOS operating system, or Linux operating system, that we have to define in a terminal type. Next one is terminal speed. Here we have to check out the speed of the data before transmitting. We have to fix the data, then approximately the server can wait only limited amount of time. The data should be reached to the destination within that prescribed time. That is terminal speed. That is the line mode. It allows the client to switch to the line mode from default mode. Okay, next, option negotiation. To use any of the option mentioned in the previous section, first requires option negotiation between the client and server. Option negotiation, it means how much time, and then operating system, everything we have to check out, and then plus or minus we have to negotiate the data transmitting and receiving. Four control characters are used for this purpose, that are character, code, meaning 1, meaning 2, and meaning 3. It means It can, however, we are going for different character mode, it can use a different meaning. That characters are will, won't, do, don't. These are the four characters we have to use in option negotiation. And then coders are will, 251 code we have to use, offering to enable, and then meaning to is accepting to enable. And then third option is meaning is not there, and then won't, 252 is code, rejecting to enable, offering to disable, and accepting to disable the connection. Do, 253 is in code, approving to enable, requesting to enable. Don't, 254, disapproving to enable, disapproving to disable, and requesting to disable. These, how these characters can works in detail, we will study in the next video. This is NVT character set for option negotiation. Here, first one is enabling an option. An enabling option is enabled either through offer or request. Okay, how it can offer to enable, a party can offer to enable option, the offering can approving or disapproved by the other party. It means here sender can send the two characters, first one is will and do or don't. It means will, after sending the client request, the server can say I will enable the option. Okay, and then he can reply I do enable the option or don't enable the option. The server can reply to the client. Okay, for data connection, offer to enable an option. Okay, here request to enable, a party can requesting from the other party to enabling of an option. It means the client can send, a sender machine can send the request, do enable the option, and the server can reply I will enable or I won't enable. Both, if the user want to enable, he can send the request I will enable. Either he don't want, it means he won't enable the, or I won't enable the option. Like this, they can send the response to the client. Okay. Next one is disabling an option. So an option that has been enabled can be disabled by one of the parties. It means offer to disable, a party can offer disable an option. The other party must approve the offering. It cannot be disapproved. It means here is also the client can send the won't, I won't use the option anymore. Then that time receiver can send I don't use it. It means I don't, it directly they can close the option or communication. Offer to disable an option, if client don't want to communicate with the server can reply don't continue to the communication or connection. Then that time they can disable the connection. Here next one is request to disable, a party can request from another party the disabling of an option. It cannot be rejected. It means they must have to disable the connection. It means sender can send the don't use the option anymore. Then that time the server can reply I won't. It means they can disable the connection from client and server. Okay, next, think and write. It can contains one question. What is an option? Describe with an example. Now pause the video and answer the above question. Now answer for the next above question is, options are extra features available to user with a more sophisticated terminal. Okay, the example, the client wants the server to echo each character sent to the server. It means this client is sending some data to the server. The data should be echoed to the server side. How it can? It means the client can send the do enable the echo option. Here we have to use the echo command, do command, and ISE. ISE is an interpret as a character. And then after sending this one, the data will go to the server side. The server can reply echo will IAC. IAC is a special combination of characters used to display the data in the both sides. It means here they have to use echo, do enable, and then IAC. And then in the receiver side, the receiver have use echo, I will enable, and then it can disable display the data in the client side. Okay, I will enable the echo option. It means whatever the data is sent by the users, that can echo in the client side as well as server side. When it can display in the client side means after sending the data from the server side. Okay, this is an echo option. symmetry. One interesting features of Telnet is its symmetric option negotiation, in which the client and server are given equal opportunity. It means both client and server have a equal weightage in a communication. It means if while transmitting the data from client to the server and server to the client, both the users should be active. If any one user is don't want to communicate, then that time automatically the whole communication will be disconnected. At the beginning of connection, it is assumed that both sides are using a default telnet implementation to options enabled. Okay. And then sub option negotiation, some options require additional information that are character, decimal, binary, and then meaning. SE and then SE is in sub option end and sub option beginning. For that, we have to use a decimal 248, 250. And then this is a binary value of these values. Okay. Symmetry, sub option negotiation example, define the type, speed of the terminal. The option negotiation includes a string number to define the type or speed. Okay, here just in the example, how we have to the client terminal type will IAC and then do enable terminal option, and then here terminal type will IAC, and then here do enable terminal option IAC do and then terminal type, and then at the end both side we have to use the sub symmetry character, that is SE and SB, sub option A end and sub option beginning, and then IAC TV terminal type and IAC is then terminal virtual, and then IAC interpret as a control, and the terminal type we have to mention, and then both the users they can display the data in both the side, that is symmetry, that is both client and server have equal weightage. Okay. These are the references I have referred for preparing the above PPT. Thank you.